how do I get a video or a portion of a video from YouTube and put it in the Descript project editor to add it to a project or add it as a B-roll? So that is actually possible and it's quite easy to do. So my usual project with my friend Chris Menard here, and I have it just a composition. You can actually create a new composition or you can just add something to a composition that already exists. I'm actually going to show you just how to add a piece of video from YouTube or an entire video to your project. So this is very easy. In Descript now, this is a new feature that was added. So you go to the project section inside of your projects. You have to open a project, create a new project. You go inside it and you go to the project. And then in the files area, you have to click this little icon here that says import files. So when you click that, you've got two options. You can import from Zoom, which we've discussed before. Importing from Zoom requires you to have a Zoom recording in the cloud, or import from URL. So when you do that, it's going to say, okay, do you want to paste a link to a YouTube video? So I'm going to go ahead to my YouTube channel and I'm going to copy a link to a YouTube video and just paste it in here in this little box. What's going to happen is Descript is going to then import that YouTube video straight into your project in here. Okay, so you need to give it a minute or two. It depends on how long the video is. This all happens behind the scenes. I don't know if it's actually faster doing it on your machine or not. I'm guessing this is happening, you know, in the cloud to cloud kind of thing. So we will have to give it a minute to download that video. And there you go. It's completed. And now if you look in the files area, you should be able to see that video somewhere in here. And watch this. It's at the bottom. This was my video about the difference between sequences and compositions in Descript Underlord. That's my video right there. It shows up like a file. Okay. So right now I have the video in my project. How do I put this video on my composition? Well, there's two ways to do it. You can easily just open your timeline and kind of zoom out so that you can see what you're doing, right? So like this. And you can just grab that file and drag it down here at the bottom on your timeline. Boom. And there's my video right there. It's now starts at the end of my video and goes on. Now, the reason you don't see the text in the script here is because this video has just been imported, but it has not been transcribed. So if you want to actually bring that video into Descript and edit with the transcript, you have to transcribe that video. Okay, that's one thing. Because you notice here, this is the video file, but there are no words above the timeline. And also, it doesn't have the quote symbol on the icon, which means that video is not transcribed. So very easily, even if I've already added that video down there in my composition, you can transcribe that video and it's going to start showing the words, right? So you can right click on that video and say transcribe file. And Descript is going to ask you what language is it and click transcribe. Who's on the video? This is me. I'm just going to select from the list here. This is me. And then I will just say done. So now Descript is transcribing that video. It shouldn't take long. And as you can see here, it says transcribing. And as soon as that's finished, you're going to notice that in my script area, this little clip here is going to disappear. And instead, you're going to see the text from that video. And, you know, transcription is quite fast, so it should be a few seconds. Okay, so that video, when it's going to be finally transcribed, it's going to play after my content here. So just like it was part of the initial recording all the time. Okay, so that's one way to do that. Let's wait for that to finish. And while that's happening, there's another way. If you don't want the video to be part of another composition, if you just want to create a composition with that video, just that video and edit it, very easy. You can have multiple compositions in the same Descript project. You can simply right-click on the video and say new composition from file. And that's going to create a completely separate composition, not a project, a composition in the same project with that video. And you can create a different edit from that, right? So like this. I'm not going to do this right now because look, the transcription has finished and there is my YouTube video right there with the transcription. And that video actually plays now after this content, piece of that content, which is my interview, my initial clip from my interview, let's say, right? So that's like 3 minutes long, and then my video starts. Okay, so that's one way to bring the video right in there in the timeline. Now, there's another scenario of this where maybe you don't actually want to use the entire video for an edit like this. Maybe you just want to use a clip from the video, maybe like B-roll. Okay, so B-roll means like, you know, secondary video that you're using while you're talking, while you're illustrating something, and you can use that as separate video and play it while you're, you know, talking about something else. So the way to do that, obviously, you have to bring that video not down here in the script area. You have to bring that video up there as a separate layer, right? So above your script. How do I do this? Well, there's one way. You just grab it from here and move it up at the top. Look at that. And that video becomes a layer on my composition playing simultaneously with my initial interview or video. Now, when you take that video out of the script track, the transcript doesn't show up anymore in the script because that's the track that produces the transcript, right? The video is still transcribed. That's not a problem. It just doesn't show here. Look, so my video here finishes with these words, which were in the previous video. So now my video from YouTube is on the top, is above this. So I can cut it like this. I can make it shorter or longer. I can make it very short if I want to, just pull from the beginning and make it really short. And there you go. So now my video is going to play. This is my interview, you know, and then I can actually show this one appearing, you know, in the middle of my interview for a while and then keep going like that. Okay. So that's one, like a B-roll. Now, the problem with this is it's not easy to control the beginning and the end of that B-roll clip, okay? How do you know which part of the YouTube video do you want to use in there, okay? Which is why I recommend that you create a separate composition for that YouTube clip, and you go in and identify the fragment you want to copy, copy that, and paste it in here, okay? Let me show you how to do that. So I already added this as a B-roll in here, but you know, you can use the slip tool, by the way. The slip tool is here to kind of shift the video inside of that little container. And you see, as I'm pulling it, I am moving the video back and forth. That's not really helping because, again, it's very hard to preview what I'm actually doing. So I'm going to click the select tool, click on that B-roll, and delete that. Okay, let me show you how to bring in a specific portion of that YouTube video from another place in the exact place you want. So the first of all, let's define where do I want to show that? Okay, I'm going to go in my transcript in here and I'm going to identify the place where I want to put that video clip as B-roll, okay? So let's say that I want to have on this paragraph. So I'm selecting this paragraph and then I'm saying, okay, while we are talking on this paragraph, I want my video from YouTube to show up, okay? Don't worry about the portion of the video right now. We're going to go and get that, okay? So make a selection in text and then press /// on your keyboard. And what that's going to do is it's going to define two scene boundaries, one at the top and one at the bottom. So my paragraph is now isolated in a scene just by itself. And you can see on the sidebar here that one scene appeared, scene number two, right? So for that scene number two, just so we identify it, I'm just going to put myself full screen for no particular reason. Here we go. So you see now the thumbnail reflects the layout of that scene. Now, this is going to be the part where I'm going to go and bring a portion of that YouTube clip into this particular scene here. Okay, so for that... If you look at the timeline, that's the portion I'm going to fill with my clip, all right, as a separate layer. So I'm going to actually go to my video from YouTube in the file panel. And by the way, you can resize this if you want to. And I'm going to right click on it and say new composition from file. And this creates a new composition just with that YouTube video. Okay. And I can see the text, of course, because that's, you know, it's been transcribed. So all you need to do is navigate inside of this composition and find the place you want to cut and take with you to the other place, okay? So for me, I'm going to actually go to the very beginning when I am full screen and I'm going to grab a portion of this clip, right? So here we go. I'm selecting down here and say, you know what? I want to grab the first paragraph of this video like this. Now, if you copy it like that, you're going to copy with the text. What I recommend is you do this. You go down here and you look at the timeline and say, oh, that's the part I want to copy. Okay. I'm going to press /. To kind of isolate that. You can do this. You can isolate this with a /. Into a first scene. Look at this. You see there? First scene. And I have this clip here. And I can copy this. You can do it with the range tool as well. If you don't want to create scenes or everything, you just use the range tool, which is here. Or you press R on your keyboard. And then you just make your selection like this on the timeline. Okay? So this gives you a precise selection. And you can, by the way, you can modify this. Sorry, let me undo that. You can modify this selection by dragging the edges like that. You know, look at this. So that is my selection. And I'm going to copy that. Right click and copy, or Command or Control C. So I copied this, right? You can go down in the scene down there on the timeline and click here and paste. So here we go. This is my clip now. And you see, I only brought in that particular piece. It wasn't precisely the length of that scene, so it brought in a bit longer. I can pull the end and just, you know, cut it off and make it shorter like this. There you go. So my video now fits inside of that scene. I can cut the beginning if I want to, delete that, and there you go. There's my video. Now, one thing I need to do, I need to mute that, okay? Because I don't want to hear the sound. So I click on that and then go to layer and then click on the audio control here to mute. Because I don't want to hear that sound as a B-roll. So watch this. Now it's coming in. We're talking and then boom, there's that video showing up. And at the end of that scene, it goes away. Okay. So here we go. That's how you add a portion of a YouTube video on top of the other video as a separate layer. If you want to paste words, paste inside the words part. So go here and paste like that. And it keeps adding them in the script. If you want to paste here, paste, click and paste like that. There you go. So it depends where you click before you paste, kind of. Okay. To be honest, there's a lot going on in the Descript timeline that sometimes the system doesn't really know what you're trying to do. So many events and clicks and selections. Okay. I hope that made sense on how to import a video from YouTube using the link. Transcribe it if you want. If you're just going to use it as a B-roll, don't transcribe it, but you still have to create a separate composition. This is my recommendation. Create a separate composition with that video and then go and play it and scrub through and figure out which segment you want to copy. Isolate that copy of the segment. You just, you know, cut it with the blade or use the range tool. Copy. Then you go and paste it where you need it. That is the most precise way that I can come up with to clearly identify which portion of a video you want to copy and import.